Mr. President, I rise on another matter, and that's to recognize a very important event occurring this Sunday and Monday. What is that? 89 World War II veterans from the state of Montana will take part in the Big Sky Honor Flight and come to Washington, D.C. to visit their monument, the World War II Memorial. Their trip is hosted by the Big Sky Honor Flight program. The mission is to recognize American veterans for their sacrifices and achievements by flying them to Washington, D.C. to see their memorials at no cost. They raise money for Montanans all across the state to make this possible. I've helped participate. It's steak fries, et cetera. And in today's economy, their generosity, the Montana's generosity in paying for these flights is really something special. And don't forget, it has to be two tickets, one for the vet and one for the person helping the vet, because these World War II vets have been around several years and they often need a little bit of assistance. One of the passengers on Sunday's flight is a 102-year-old, his name is Dr. McDonald W. Held of Billings, Montana, 102 years old. Don's had a remarkable life. He's been a United States Air Force intelligence worker, a professor, an author, a minister, and a college president. Don was born in 1909. What was going on in 1909? Well, that year, President Taft was inaugurated as the 27th president. The U.S. Army received its first delivery from the Wright brothers. Congress passed the Homestead Act, which resulted in a large influx of settlers all across the West, including my state of Montana. Don graduated from Baylor University in 1933 with a degree in speech. Although he earned his master's and doctoral degrees from Northwestern University, Don's heart remained at Baylor. He wears a Baylor workout suit every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday when he exercises at the Billings YMCA. Remember, Don's 102 years old. During World War II, Don served in the Air Force as an intelligence officer in the Philippines. After the peace treaty signed, he was stationed in Tokyo. He worked just a couple buildings down from General Douglas MacArthur. After the war, Don embarked on his career in academics. He served as Howard Payne University as a professor there in 1955 to 64, presided over the speech and theater department, and served as academic dean. Don then worked for 7 years at Wayland Baptist University before moving to Billings, Montana. In Billings, he became the first head of the speech and theater department at the Eastern Montana College that we now know as Montana State University, Billings. At age 74, Don was ordained as a minister in the Baptist Church. He has ministered in three churches in Montana, also served as president of the Yellowstone Baptist Bible Institute, now the Yellowstone Baptist College. Don and his wife, Beverly, have five children, five grandchildren, seven great-grandchildren so far. His son, Don Jr., a veteran of the Vietnam War, will escort him to Washington this Sunday. This is a special weekend for this group of heroes. Believe me, I was here when the last honor flight came in. I cannot remember a time when I've been so, so touched by people. And you see these World War II vets, some men, and most of the men and women, they're just talking about their experiences. They're the greatest generation, as been mentioned before, especially by Tom Brokaw. It's time to give them thanks for their courage. Time to give them thanks for their sacrifice. They've done so much. And it's time to reflect on all the sacrifices they've made. Just think of it. On the battles of Europe, Korea, jungles of Vietnam, deserts of Iraq, and those who are currently fighting in the mountains of Afghanistan. We must not forget them. Please join me in welcoming our Montana heroes to Washington this weekend. I'm going to be down there, and I know many others will too.